Hi there, in this new video tutorial I am going to show you how to solve this problem. In GameMaker, when you are drawing text and scaling your view, you will see that the text gets bigger and bigger. So in this video I'm going to show you how to get rid of this problem. Now let's see the code I'm using to draw the text. This line of code is okay if you're not using scaling and rotation in your views, but if you do, then you won't want to use this approach. Probably this is the most common way to draw text in GameMaker, using the ViewXView and the ViewYView. So we are not using this anymore. Now I'll use this different approach. As you can see here, I'm drawing the text using this function, and you can see this line of code enclosed between these two set projection functions. In the first one, I set a new projection for the text, and in the second one, I'm restoring the previous projection I was using. Now let's see it. Well, here is the game again. Now I am going to scale the view, and now you can see the text is shown properly. And now if I rotate the view, you can see something interesting. When I rotate the view, the background and the tiles are being rotated, but the objects don't. As you can see, now we have a new problem. Let's back to the code. This is why the second instruction is not restoring the angle of our previous projection. If you see here in the last argument is the angle argument. So I'm storing the angle of my view rotation in a variable named angle. Not very original. And that's it. Now the projection is restored, and the angle is restored as well. So now it should work perfectly. Now I'm going to scale the view, and the text is drawn properly. And now I'm going to rotate the view, and the text remains the same, and the background tiles and now objects are rotated. So it seems we fix the problem for view scaling and rotation. So let's back to the code. Well, here it is. Pretty simple. Don't forget to put your view width and height in the third and fourth argument in the first projection instruction, and don't forget to put the angle in the last projection instruction. And that's it. Okay, Hope you find this useful.